Hello and welcome to the Pro Football Hall of Fame's On the Road to Excellence. I am senior activator and producer of national programs for the Pro Football Hall of Fame, Jameer Howerton, and I'm honored to be joined by Gold Jacket Pro Football Hall of Famer and Buffalo Bills legend Thurman Thomas. Thomas, thank you very much for joining us.
Not a problem, man. You might want to hit the windshield wipers a little bit more.
I know. See, you know, this is a really cool new feature that we're having here at the Pro Football Hall of Fame. This is a good time to be at the Hall.
It is,
Mr. Thomas.
It is.
There's a lot of things going on. There's a lot of cool content that we're trying to produce for our fan base.
Yes.
And so we're on the road to excellence. We're celebrating the 6th year of the U.S. Army Pro Football Hall of Fame Award for Excellence, where we're going around the country celebrating the excellence of 25 high school finalists. Yep. And today we just landed in Houston, Texas, and we're on the highway. So we figured, you know what, Jerry Seinfeld has his comedians in the car for coffee. I said, you know what, we got our gold jackets in the car, so let's talk a little football. Let's talk a little bit about everything. Let's check in and let our fan base know what our Hall of Famers are doing.
Let's do it.
So with
it
that,
it might not go viral like
No.
Seinfeld, but we'll be okay.
But you know what? You never know. Okay. You never know. It may. But when you look at the program, the U.S. Army Pro Football Hall of Fame Award for Excellence, Mr. Thomas, and you look at that, and you look at the way the two institutions have come together, the Hall with the U.S. Army, to celebrate the excellence of these young high school student athletes.
Yes.
What does this say to you to see how these guys have come together to produce this and to celebrate these kids?
Well, you know what? It's all about these kids and how hard they work and how they're able to lead other students. And you know, when you talk about the Pro Football Hall of Fame, it's kind of in that way too, how we're kind of leaders of the community, leaders on the field. And to see these young kids do this at a young time in their life is really awesome. And to be associated with the U.S. Army, which, you know, God bless them, you know, they're protecting us. And but to see these kids really involved in the community, involved in a lot of different things, man, it's just so great to see them. And like I said, this is my second time that I'm doing this,
you know? Right.
First time doing an interview like this, but my second time doing this, going to another school to present an award to a kid who is a hard worker, has good grades, does a lot of stuff in the community,
right,
which Hall of Famers do all the time too.
Absolutely.
Work hard to where we got to right now, but we also give back to the community. So be on the road to going to present another award to another high school kid is just absolutely amazing.
You know, Mr. Baker, our president and CEO, always makes reference that, hey, you know what, our guys just didn't, our gold jackets just didn't roll out the bed as Hall of Famers.
Right.
If you could just share with us some of your fondest memories of just being on the grind and because that road wasn't easy.
No.
You know, it wasn't like, voila, I'm a Pro Football Hall of Famer. There's some work that had to go, you know, there was work that was put in.
Well, you know what, and the thing that I had an opportunity to do, my first year was 1988, and so once I got into the league and after my first year, I got to see how Jim Kelly worked. God bless him. You got to see how Bruce Smith worked, Darrell Talley, Andre Reed. Guys, not all these guys are Hall of Famers, but we got a couple of Jim and Andre. But to see how these guys work day in and day out, they never took a day off.
Right.
They never took a day off. And to be a part of something like that, I was like, you know what? I have to do this in order for me to succeed in the National Football League, but also have an opportunity to make it to the Pro Football Hall of Fame. And I've been retired now for 17 years. And I still work just as hard as I do the stuff that I have going on in my life, because it's in my blood. That's what I have to do. That's what I want to do. I want to be able to get out in the community, help people to be better. And that's my life. That's what I love to do.
Wow, that's amazing. That's amazing. You know, it's so fitting that we're on the road. And when you think about it, I got to ask you, you know, through your illustrious career, talk about some of the road trips that you just, the stadiums that you just hated playing in. Like, that you just knew, like, oh man, we gotta go here this week. You look at the schedule and you're just planning out, you know, your road trips for the for that year.
Well, you know what? Two stadiums that I hated going to. Pittsburgh Steelers.
Wow.
When it was back, it was Three River Stadium.
Okay.
I'm showing my age here a little bit, you know. And Arrowhead Stadium, where the Kansas City Chiefs play. Loud. Both stadiums are loud. I mean, we couldn't hear, you know, back then, you know, we were trying to do the silent count and all this stuff, and it just didn't work. But the fans there are great. Obviously, having the Kansas City Chiefs and the Pittsburgh Steelers, two of the dominant organizations in the National Football League for a long period of time, especially with the Pittsburgh Steelers. I mean, they've won six Super Bowls.
Right.
That's like amazing, you know. Right. I grew up a Pittsburgh. I grew up a Joe Green fan.
Wow.
Me and Joe Green fan.
Wow.
Know? He's from North Texas State University. And
you know what's so funny? Wow, that's real. Because the first autograph that I've ever gotten from any football player was me and Joe Green.
No way.
Because I wanted I wanted to be that kid.
Yeah, right.
In that commercial.
Right.
And I said to my mother, I was like, Mom, how do I one day be on TV, one, and then two, I want to be that kid.
Yeah.
And not only was it the first autograph that I got,
really?
But yeah, and then like my mother actually like worked it out that I started, you know, as a childhood actor and acting, and it was all behind Mean Joe Green and that commercial.
I love that, man. It was a great commercial.
Wow. Sorry to divert.
But no, that's okay. No, that's okay. I mean, Mean Joe Green was one of the first professional football players that I ever met, and that's why I became growing up, even though I lived here in Houston, I was a Pittsburgh Steelers fan. And I wasn't a fan of, like, the Houston Oilers. I was a fan of, like, Earl Campbell.
Right.
I was a fan of Earl Campbell, number 34, the Tyler Rose. That was my guy there. That was the reason why I wore 34. And you know, and I met Mean Joe. I just kind of became a fan of the Pittsburgh Steelers. And so, but, playing in Pittsburgh, man, I hated playing there. It was always on a Monday night, it seems like, going against Kevin Green, who's in the Hall of Fame.
Right.
Greg Lord, who should be in the Hall of Fame. I mean, just going against those guys. It was just an uncomfortable place to be playing at on a Monday night, but I probably should be at home in my bed, you know? And but it was the opposite, you know? When Pittsburgh came to Buffalo, it was tough for them.
Right.
But Kansas City and Pittsburgh, man, just two places that I hated going to. But one of the places that I did love going to was down in South Beach to play the Miami Dolphins.
Wow.
We actually called the stadium at that time. It was Joe Robbie.
Okay.
We called it Rich Stadium South.
Wow.
Playing
so
up
had to get
Buffalo.
Some stone crabs the night before the game.
That was
mandatory.
When we landed, Bruce Smith had the stone crabs all set up for us. So we were always good in that department.
But yeah.
It was just, you know, great to get out of the winter and go down into South Beach and play a game when it was 70, 80 degrees. But definitely you look back, Kansas City and Pittsburgh, hated those stadiums. Absolutely hated them.
Now when you're on the road, did you ever like have like any rituals, like any superstitions that you had to pack this T-shirt, that pair of pajamas, or whatever? You know, just anything like that?
No, I didn't. You know, it started off, you know, very kind of low key with me. I roomed with a veteran guy. His name was Leonard Smith.
Okay.
He got traded from the Phoenix, from the Arizona Cardinals, St. Louis Cardinals, to the Buffalo Bills in 1988. And he was my roommate for 3 or 4 years, and so we didn't have any rituals. He did. You know, he was from Louisiana.
Okay.
Yeah,
okay.
So the first time I encountered with, like, rituals and things like that was we were sitting at a breakfast table Sunday morning, sitting across from him, and he pulls out his pocket, like, a bag. I'm like, man, what's in that bag? You know, I didn't ask him that, but I'm just kind of looking at him. And pulls out he shakes the bag a little bit, and he opens it, and it's like little, like, bones. Oh, yeah, I don't know. It wasn't human bones.
Right.
But it was just like little bones, you know, and he would set them up in a certain way and talk to them, and I was like, now that right there is a ritual right there. I mean, I love football, but I'm not going to be like that right there. So, man. But no, I never really did have any rituals before the game or whatever. I think my first 9 years in the league, I had to be, when we went out for the introductions, I had to be like third from last one out on the football field.
Okay.
You know, things like that, but nothing like had to wear the same T-shirt or like Michael Jordan had to wear his North Carolina shorts
right.
under his Chicago Bulls shirt.
Right,
that
right.
wasn't anything
it wasn't like that.
That wasn't anything like that. You know, I just went like, you know what, go out and play the game and just see
That's
what
it.
Happens. Yeah, so
That's it.
None of that was really involved with me going out and playing the game and having a ritual or anything like that.
Cool. Well, we're here in Texas, and you know, you grew up in Houston, and we passed a high school here just a few minutes ago.
Yes.
But let's talk about high school football here in Texas. The magnitude.
Man. I mean, we can talk for the next 2 hours about it. I mean, it's, you know, we started, my high school that I went to, Willow Ridge High School, was a new high school. It had only been open for about 3 or 4 years until, you know, I got there. But as powerful as football is here in the state of Texas, we had a group of guys, man, that wanted to play football.
Right.
New program. We wanted to be on the map. And we had some outstanding athletes going into a new high school.
Okay.
I mean, one of the athletes that we have, and you probably have heard this name before, is Isaiah Washington.
Okay.
Isaiah Washington used to play on Grey's Anatomy.
Okay.
That's why I went to high school with him.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. So.
And he played ball, too?
He played ball, too.
Wow.
Yeah. So after he left high school, he went to his acting career or whatever.
Okay.
But, and we stay in touch a lot. But, yeah, it was one of those deals where we had a bunch of athletes. I mean, I think it was our fourth year, we ended up going to a state championship.
Okay.
We ended up losing to Brownwood 15-14. But the following year, we came back. I was a junior with a lot of seniors.
In 10 miles, turn right.
15-0, won the state championship in like our fifth year in existence. And it kind of put us on the map, you know. But leading up to that Friday,
man.
Unbelievable. I mean, you know.
Because the whole city shuts down.
You've heard stories of a whole city shutting down.
Right.
Yeah, I mean, it was a perfect, like I always tell people, it was a perfect time if you wanted to rob somebody. Friday night was the night to do it because everybody was at the football game.
Wow.
So I mean, it was outstanding, man, and it's and it's still that way today.
That's cool.
And we had a really good football high school, and not only that, we won a couple of back-to-back high school basketball championships. We've had kids. That have been at that school, that have went to the Olympics. Mm-hmm. So, I mean, it was a pretty predominant high school back in the day, but football was number one. And no matter what anybody says here in Texas about basketball, baseball, or whatever, football will always remain number one.
That's cool. Well, we're all over the place here with this conversation, Mr. Thomas, but of course, the eats. Let's talk about the good food that Texas has to offer.
Oh, man.
And
is there Papa Do's
around here? That's what I... Fried alligator. Fried alligator.
I can't eat fried alligator.
No?
No, because my daughter went to the University of Florida, so.
Oh, okay.
I'm not allowed to.
You're not allowed to eat fried alligator?
I'm not allowed to eat fried alligator.
Okay,
so
okay.
We can't do that.
Yeah.
But it's good, though.
That's
I had
cool.
it before she went to Florida, so I know what it tastes like. But no, it's, the food down here tremendous, man. You got everything. You got steaks. Seafood. I mean, you got everything down here. You got some Creole, because Louisiana is just right over there somewhere.
Okay.
Know, not that far from the border, but
right.
You got great Mexican food down there. I mean, you got it.
That's
all
right.
Down here. I'm telling you.
Yeah,
you got
we got
it.
Some fajitas down here.
But see, the seafood can go with Papa Do's. The fajitas can go to Papacitos.
Papacitos, yes.
There you go. And they got a steakhouse down there. I'm just giving the Papa Do's boys all the credit in the world right now. They got
throwing them mad love.
They got a steakhouse, Papa Steakhouse. I mean, they got it all.
They got it locked
there.
Down.
They got it locked down down there. But besides them, it's just food at every single block.
Right.
Down
right.
here in the state of Texas, man.
Right.
It's something that, man, these people down here, man, they thrive on it. Barbecue, wow. All that type of stuff. I mean, it's unbelievable down here. Food is great.
This is cool, man. Like I said, this is a new feature here that we're having at the Pro Football Hall of Fame, and there's just so much content that you can visit us on profootballhof.com. Mr. Thomas has been a part of the heart of a Hall of Famer,
yep.
Where you came to Canton and spoke to the kids, and now this is your second year doing this U.S. Army Pro Football Hall of Fame Award for Excellence. So there's this great content that we're just trying to pub out, and
yep.
We hope you like this. And
I'll be down at the Hall of Fame for the Hall of Fame draft party.
Oh, see? I'll still be on the road, covering the cities, but my colleagues will be there.
I got you, yeah. You'll miss that one, but yeah, hey, we'll be there. I'll be there.
That's right.
You know, I mean, I just love them. I mean, going to Canton, man, you just see everything.
Mm.
And I'm really excited for all the guys that got in. I told, like, as soon as, like, Terrell, Ray Lewis, Randy Moss, who my family absolutely loves.
Wow.
They're like, wow. I mean, when he got in, I must have had about at least 30 to 40 people text me.
Wow.
I'm going. I'm like, I don't know if I can get that many tickets.
You know what? Let me tell you something. It was so crazy, and everybody can go back and check the records, but Gold Jacket Brett Favre,
yeah.
He was actually on camera, and he was like, whoa, this may be the class. This may be the class to go win.
Yeah.
This is something special about this class.
It is something special about this class. I mean, with all the guys that are going in, and it's going to be special. I mean, Brian Dawkins has been a really good friend of mine for a number of years, but all these guys have.
Right.
Even when you go talk back to Bobby Beathard and all those guys, Jerry Kramer. I mean, right. Jerry Kramer, my running back coach for the Buffalo Bills was Elijah Pitts, who passed away 10-15 years ago. Used to talk about Jerry Kramer all the time because they played with the Green Bay Packers.
Wow.
In the first two Super Bowls.
Wow.
And he used to always talk about, I can't believe this guy's not in the Pro Football Hall of Fame. And he's in it now. And so when I see Jerry, man, and his whole family, man, I'm going to talk about Eli.
Wow.
I'm going to talk about him. I know he's going to light up because Eli was a special friend to him. But all those Green Bay Packers all those Green Bay Packers players were at that time. And it's just good to see those guys. And really, man, it's going to be an unbelievable weekend. And hope everybody come out and just enjoy it, man. Because this class here, man, this is a beautiful class
It is a beautiful class.
It is a beautiful class.
I can't wait.
Man, I can't wait.
I can't wait. I can't wait to hear the speeches.
Oh, it's going to tear up.
Because you already know Ray Lewis is going to give it up.
Ray Lewis is going to go about 30 minutes.
Now, I know there's a secret meeting amongst the Gold Jackets.
Oh, yeah, no doubt.
So would that be like one of the things that you guys going to corner them and let them know, like, listen, man.
Oh, yeah.
I get it.
I'm telling you, somebody's already gotten his ear already. Yeah, Ray, we know you give great speeches, but we don't need one to go 30, 40 minutes. You can give a great 15-minute speech with everything in your life, and that'll be fine. But when you have seven guys go in, it's going to be a long night.
It's going to be a long night.
It's going to be a long night. So you know what? Enjoy it. Talk as long as you want to. Just enjoy it, man, because it only happened once.
That's it.
You're only going to the Pro Football Hall of Fame once.
That's it.
And enjoy it with your friends, your family, and the team that everybody always say you can go in and you'll never be cut from.
Wow. Wow. There you have it. Gold Jacket, Thurman Thomas. We're here, Houston, Texas. We're on the road, so be sure to check us out at profootballhof.com, where we'll have from Palacios High School. Check us out, man, and we'll see you again from on the road with the Pro Football Hall of Fame, on the road to excellence.